Well, so Glenn Simpson lays out that his colleague Christopher Steele, who was gathering information on Donald Trump's alleged connections with Russians from his Russian sources overseas, grew so concerned that he reached out to the FBI in July and finally sat down with his FBI contact in Rome in September for what was described as a full debriefing. But by that time, Steele told Simpson, and Simpson told the committee, the FBI had already been told about potential collusion. They had already had an Australian diplomat come to them and say, hey, this guy George Papadopoulos, his campaign aide, has told me about the Russians having some Democratic emails. And so the FBI had already become concerned that there was an issue here with the Trump campaign. We now know that they opened a criminal investigation in July of 2016. But Steele didn't know that. So he grew disillusioned. He thought the FBI wasn't taking his concerns seriously, which is why he and Simpson started, this information started making its way to reporters, Ali.
And in the end, Ken, the Senate committee has broken this down into about seven specific things they're asking for. In other words, it's not this generalized complaint about collusion with the Trump campaign or Russian interference in the election. They want Congress to look at seven specific things, including how state election systems were affected, how we can keep them stronger, how we can deal with social media disinformation. So they've got some sort of an end game here.
That's right. Well, this is Congress saying, look, leave aside what happened in the 2016 election. We have a public policy issue here. We have not dealt with the problem of how we stop the Russians from attacking the next time. And that's absolutely the case. There's been no whole of government effort to deal with this that we have seen, Ali. And this is Congress saying, look, Trump administration, get your act together. Here's some things you can do. We'll see how the Trump administration responds.